In this visit, I'm going to go through the Framingham Risk Score for men. Heart Attack Risk Assessment 2 for women is the same visit but for women, because the point value charts are different for men and for women. Now, if you're having any symptoms like chest pain, heartburn, indigestion, fatigue, shortness of breath, swelling in your ankles and feet, or any other symptom, you need to see the doctor right away. If you're having symptoms, you could be at high risk, even if you answer no to the 10 questions, and even if your Framingham risk score is low. Seeing the doctor can prevent a heart attack. If you answered no to the 10 questions in Heart Attack Risk Assessment 1 visit, and you're not having any symptoms, then determining your Framingham risk score is the next step in determining your risk. To calculate your Framingham risk score, you need to know your total cholesterol level and your HDL cholesterol. You need to have a blood pressure measurement, and you'll need to answer some questions. If you don't yet have the blood test and blood pressure measurements, remember that you can order your cholesterol test yourself online without a doctor's order. Just go to Google and type in blood tests, and you'll find companies that can do this for you. The test you'll want to order is the lipid panel. And you can get your blood pressure measurement at lots of drugstores or supermarkets. Even if you haven't yet gotten your test, you could still go through this visit to see how it's done. First, get a pen and a blank piece of paper and put numbers down the left side from 1 through 6. I'll ask you to answer 6 questions. Question 1, your age. 2, your total cholesterol level. 3, your HDL cholesterol level, the good cholesterol. 4, your systolic blood pressure. That's the top number, the bigger number of your two blood pressure numbers. 5, are you taking medicine for high blood pressure? And 6, do you smoke? We'll assign points to each answer, add up all the points, and then calculate the risk from the total points. We'll do the example first, and then we'll go through your answers together and figure your risk. First, the example. The man is 51 years old and he feels healthy. His total cholesterol is 250, and his HDL cholesterol is 33. His blood pressure is 142 over 86, so his systolic blood pressure is 142. Systolic blood pressure is the first of the two blood pressure numbers. He is being treated for high blood pressure, and he smokes cigarettes. Now let's go through his questions and give points. Question 1, age 51 years. We look at the age chart, and it shows he gets 6 points for his age. So write down that number after his age. That's the points for this question. Question 2, total cholesterol. His is 250 and his age is 51. We go across the cholesterol row to his age column, and we see that he gets 4 points. Question 3, HDL cholesterol. His is 33. So we look at the HDL cholesterol chart, and he gets 2 points. Questions 4 and 5. His blood pressure is 142 over 86, and he is being treated for high blood pressure. So he gets 2 points once. There's only 1 point score for questions 4 and 5 together. And finally, question 6. He smokes and is 51 years old, so he gets 3 points. So his total score is added together, and he has a total of 17 points. Now we look at the total point chart to determine the patient's risk. We see that he has 17 points, and his risk then of having a heart attack or of dying from a heart attack over the next 10 years is 30% or more. This means he's at high risk despite feeling fine and having no symptoms. But with medicine and healthy living habits, he can cut his risk by 50% or more. Now it's time to calculate your Framingham risk score. Get a paper and pen and write numbers 1 through 6 down the left margin of the paper. Get your cholesterol blood test results and your blood pressure result. You'll write down your answers next to the question numbers, and then we'll go through your answers and look at the point chart for each question. You'll write down the points next to the answer to each question. Then we'll add up all the points and then go to the risk chart to calculate your risk. How old are you? Write your age down next to number 1. What's your total cholesterol level? What's your HDL cholesterol level? What's your systolic blood pressure? And remember, this is the first number of the two blood pressure numbers. Write it down next to 4. Are you being treated for high blood pressure? Yes or no? And finally, 6. Do you smoke? Yes or no? Now we'll go through and figure the points for each question. First question chart. Find the row with your age, and then write down the points number that goes with your age next to question 1. The chart for 2 is a little more complicated, but we can still do it together. First, find the row that goes with your total cholesterol level, and then go across that row until you come to the points for your age. Write that number down next to 2's answer. The chart for question 3 is easier. Write down the points that go to your HDL cholesterol level next to 3's answer. This chart is for questions 4 and 5 together. And there's only one point value for the two questions. Question 4, your systolic blood pressure, the first of the two blood pressure numbers, and question 5, are you being treated for high blood pressure, yes or no? Go to the row for your blood pressure and then write down the points in that row depending on whether or not you're being treated for high blood pressure. Now, write that point value next to question 4. And put a line through question 5 to remind you it's already been counted. This is the chart for question 6. If you don't smoke, just put down 0 next to question 6's answer. If you do smoke, put down the points for your age. Now, we're going to add up the 5-point values that you've put down. Double-check your addition. And then now it's time to go to the risk calculation chart. Note your points box. The percentage number that is next to it is your risk of having a heart attack or dying from a heart attack over the next 10 years. High is greater than 20%, intermediate is 10 to 20%, and low is less than 10%. If your Framingham risk score showed low risk and you answered no to all the 10 high risk questions in Heart Attack Risk Assessment 1, you could still be at intermediate risk. In Heart Attack Risk Assessment 3, the last of the series, I'll go over the last part of the risk assessment. Then we can go on to prevention. If you'd like to print out the charts yourself, here's the link. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this useful.